Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
It's something that I'm not proud of, and I'm really embarrassed that it happened. And I allowed myself to get put in a situation to where it wouldn't be beneficial to the team and myself. And really, I just want to be past the situation. I've done all my obligations that the team want me to do and that the course had me do, and everybody's happy with the outcome. So I just want to move past this.
Thoughts about these photos that have been circulated on here, holding weapons. What do you say to them?
Those were something that was done as a modeling thing I did when I was in Miami, and somebody stole them. They wasn't supposed to be released, and a female stole them and put them out there like that.
What message do you think that's sending?
It's not a very good one. That's why I didn't want those released after we did it, and it was like, this didn't come out how we expected it. So it was just something that I really didn't want to get out, and then somebody stole them and released them.
What was the mediation process you went through after that? Can you talk about what?
Which one?
They said they went through a domestic violence program. What was that like? What was that about?
It was just a 14-class thing that I had to go through, and they said if I completed it before I came up here, they'd be happy and it'd get rid of my record.
What did you learn in that process, or what were those courses like?
They taught me a lot of things, like, people basically do domestic violence every day and you don't even know it. Just ignoring somebody that you love and care about is domestic violence. And I know people around town or people that you love and care about, you ignore them all the time if you don't feel like being bothered, and that's not something that you shouldn't do.
What does the Rider organization ask you to do as a result of that?
I sat down with Coach Kory Chamblin and we discussed some things, and I've fulfilled all my obligations that they asked me to fulfill. And it's just something that we're ready to put behind us now.
Why did you, the charges were in January, the team found out in March. Why was there a 2-month delay in telling the team about it?
Because I wanted to tell the team in person. I didn't want to make a phone call and give them bad news. I felt like I needed to be a man about the situation and approach the team in person and tell them what happened.
First thing I want to say is that, you know, we became aware of an incident a while back, you know, that Kory was involved with, which obviously is pretty significant. Obviously, we don't condone any of that kind of stuff. Saying that he's a member of our team, and going forward, he will be a member of our team, but that's not what we want to be all about, and our players are not going to be able to do that. Kory knows that, and he knows he's on his last strike with us. So regarding the code of conduct, you know, every situation is different. Everything is handled independently on an individual basis, and I think Corey's got on the wrong side of it right now. So we'll see where it goes in the future, but I think he knows where he stands.
What's the line for you in terms of what needs to change, or does something have to change, or what were you expecting?
Well, you know, he went through a legal process in the United States and it was deemed that he was allowed to continue to do what he needs to do and play football, and just providing that's been happening, we're going to live by that and keep it closely monitored.
When did you become aware of the charge?
I don't exactly remember exactly what date it was, but I think it was in or around March, I believe it was, and we talked to Kory, we brought him in and sat him down and told him to go through the legal process, and we'll see where it's at that point. Continuing that, he finished that process and was able to move on.
Did the charge tell you about it?
Sorry?
Did he inform you about it?
Not directly.
So when that happens, do you expect the player to maybe inform you what's going on with something like that?
He made a member of our organization, I'll put it that way.
Because the charge was in January, is it one of those you'd like to hear from them a lot sooner than 2 months after the original charge?
When that stuff happens, I'm sure there's a lot of things that goes through his mind, but I'm not going to condone what he did, obviously, in no way, shape, or form, but I think there was a little bit of an angst on his part to try to figure out what to do before he told us, but we found out, you know, in due course, and we still have some work to do with our immigration people, and again, that process will continue too.
Under the code of conduct, what can you do to discipline in this?
He'll be disciplined, but I'm not going to get into what it is.
What's the range of possibilities that you'd consider?
Like I said, I'm not going to get into that.
What are you expecting of him now?
To act like a pro and to be a Rough Rider, not what we read about and seen about.
When you talk about him, what impact is this having?
He's a good player for us, and he'll continue to be, but he can't act like he did.
When you talk about immigration issues, what are there problems in the foreseeable future with Kory being in Canada or not?
I don't want to speak on their part, but I think there's what they call minister's permits that guys can obtain, providing he passes all those tests, which he'll continue to go do. And once he does that, we'll be fine. But again, it's not a thing that we take lightly by no means, and nor do they.
But then last year you dealt with Odell Willis earlier before the season before camp started. Was there any thought about doing that this year with this case?
Well, I think part of it was he needed to get through end of May basically to get the case resolved one way or the other in the States. And had it not been resolved, we would have been able to handle it obviously right before he came up. So the timing of it, I don't know if there is a good time to handle it, but you know, we're just trying to concentrate now on football and get going.
I think anytime there's anything going on with our players personally, then, you know, as a head coach, I want to know what they're going through and make sure that their life is straight, because when your life's straight off the field, then you're going to have pretty much good success on the field. So, you know, it's one of those things to where, you know, it's been dealt with by him and the organization, and it's time to move on, and I think he'll continue to do what he needs to do to right his wrongs.
Do you feel satisfied that he has said what he needs to say and he is able to move on from this?
Well, you know, like I said, I don't know if satisfied is the word. As an organization, we've done what we needed to do from the organizational standpoint. Corey's done what he needs to do from the personal standpoint. You know, it's an ever-evolving thing from with our players and our team to make sure the guys are, you know, having a healthy lifestyle both on the field and off the field. So that's something that, you know, we'll continue to monitor to make sure the guys are doing the right things so that their careers and their lives can go in the right direction.